So, assuming the software is working the way I expect it to, Roderick is here. What's up? Let me make this a little bit bigger so I could see what's going on. There we go. Tilt this back a bit. What's going on? Welcome. Actually, I like it where it was. Check, check. Okay, cool. Roderick Williams is here. What's up? So, today this is going to be, I guess, a masterclass, so to speak, of how to become a music producer or how to be a music producer. There's a lot of folks out there who want to get into music, but they just don't know how. So let's guide them today. So I'm gonna wait for people to hop in here, make sure the stream is healthy and everything before I get into it. Let me, oh, you know what? I gotta switch tabs too. Forgot about that. All right, so shout out to everybody. We're on all platforms, I believe, if this worked properly. We got Wayne here. What's up, Wayne? AKA, dang, it's crazy. Your name, Larry G. You got like 18 different usernames. I don't know how to pronounce your letters, but shout out to you with the crown emoji and the heart. TDH is here. I just added you to that Black Hive holder, or excuse me, Black Box holder Discord group. I believe it was TDH. I might be thinking of TBD. It was T something. There was a lot of dots in there. I might be wrong. Before I start making up stuff, let me check. Might not have been you. I might be misnaming. But yes, today is all about how to become a music producer, how to be a better music producer. Let me click here real quick. Oh, whoops. Okay. Let's go to. Let me see who's a member here. Darn, it won't show me. It was T something. It's on my spreadsheet. But shout out to the people who got the black box because they have access to a private Discord room. All right, let's see who else is up in here. I gotta move the screen a little more. Boom. Ninoff is here. Carl is here. What's up? Is it's Lava is here. You ever play Lava on the floor where you gotta act like the floor is lava? I never did it as a kid, but I learned about it in college. Igor is here. Igor Arm. What's up? Austin's here. What's up? Amir is here from, I thought you said from Seattle. I thought your name said Seattle. I can't pronounce your name, so shout out to you. Yeah, just call me Blade, as my name is just Chinese. What's up, Blade? Sonam is here. What's up? We got CSI, CSI, and Ninoff is here. Larry G. That's his official name. We're not going to call you your government. I don't want to put you out there. I'll call you Larry G. As long as you keep that avatar. If you change your avatar, I'm not going to know who you are. Emmanuel, what's up? Catalan or Caitlin? Catalan? It's probably Catalan. What's up? Mad Hatter, hey game, how in the world do I become a music producer? Good question, don't we all? Zulu is here. Rain is here. We got Julian says, tell me how to be a music producer. You're learning here. Banana, oh wait, banan? Bananenbrat. Bananenbrat. Hello from Twitch land. Shout out to the Twitch folks. We're trying to grow our Twitch. I haven't learned about everything about Twitch just yet. But we're definitely going to be going live everywhere. Twitch, Facebook, YouTube. So whatever your favorite platform is, that's where we'll be. DJ Rob Snow is here. What's up? Hey, shout out to Sean is here with the fires. Putting fires out today. Streamlabs must be. I got to figure out how to turn that off. That's kind of whack. If it's blocking you from putting fire emojis. Pop J, what's up? From India. Reslo's here. We got Felix. I'm gonna be reading super slow. Vocals trying to add. Yeah, I saw you were asking that. The timing's off. The timing's off. It may be because under your options, if you go to audio settings, your buffer length is too high. That's one thing. Anytime you have a time difference between talking in your mic and the audio that goes in your DAW, it's called a buffer. So it could be a software, it could be plugins that are causing the buffer. It could be your audio buffer length. It could be a third-party software that's causing a delay. So something in your chain is causing a delay. Chances are it's a plugin. So you want to turn the plugin off while you're recording, then turn it back on. Or if you're using like an auto-tune that's not real time, then that's why you're getting that delay because it's not a real-time processor. Charles says, I've learned that when it comes to producing music, friends are far and few between. Well, you got to join our Discord. That's where everybody's making friends and partnering up and stuff. Kevin or Kevin. Hello, gang. Biscuit Beats. What's up? Roderick says, what's up? He was here early. Isaac Johansson. What's up, man? Tyrone Sellers. Welcome back. KCM from Niger. I don't know where that's at. Niger. Have no idea where that's at. Biscuit Beats from Trinidad. There we go. Ready Red says, what's up? It's the goat. Shout out to you. This is, they changed the color, so now it's like harder to read. I got to read blue text on a blue background. Man, they just won't give me a break. But shout out to everybody. So let's get into it. I think we have enough people to finally get started. It's been a while, man. I'm Anthony. Don't know if you remember me or not. I finally got FL producer bundle. Learn from you every day, man. Thank you, Anthony. It's been a while, but we still welcome you here as if you never left. In Utah. DJ Rob Snow's in Utah? You're in Utah? You would think Utah is all snow, but it's actually like mountainous and deserty looking somewhere, some places. Bergie Corrupt, what's up? All right, so it's time to get started. So I would do a poll, but I'm not on the YouTube screen. So I'll let the YouTube. So when are we gonna discuss more about the label? You just gotta join the Discord. It's not complicated. First step is just join the Discord. And then there's song submissions. We're gonna slowly work it up. I don't wanna make this super complex. It's really simple. Join our Discord at busyworksbeats.com/discord and then submit songs per the artist, per artist. So right now we're focusing on Star Castillo. Last week we focused on Keyshawn. I just sent him the record so that he could record over it. So this week we're gonna, so for those who don't know, we're starting our own record label in our Discord. We have 11,000 producers here. It's a producer city, basically. And we're gonna join forces and we're gonna make our own artists, because I'm tired of people thinking that you have to go through Sony, Universal, or Warner to like make stuff happen. We're all talented. We all have the same tools that these labels have, you know, except a couple things, you know, assets, things that are millions and millions of dollars. But outside of not having people to push stuff on the radio in your pocket and like fudge legal things, we have the same exact tools. So we're gonna be growing our own artists from the ground up. That's what this is all about. So it's a fun activity for the entire Discord, okay? So the first week we focused on an artist, Keyshawn. And again, he's in the recording process. And today I'm gonna release to the Discord the multi-tracks that Nippy Crave provided so that everybody can create remixes, you can practice mixing beats, you can, you know, chop sounds, whatever you wanna do. And we're gonna all grow together. So this isn't like a one-sided equation. So this week we're focusing on Star Castillo. She has song references, so if you're gonna submit a song, look at the song references, okay? And if you wanna learn how to submit for all this, just join our Discord. All the instructions are laid out under the announcements tab, okay? And I'll be talking about it as we go. So that's that. Okay, so she's a female artist, so it's not a male artist this time, it's a female artist, and we're gonna see what we can create with her, okay? So I wanted to make it fun for everybody. So that's Discord in a nutshell. All right, you guys ready to get rocking? We got a good amount of folks here. All right, just started. Oh, you know what I was gonna do? What's up, Lotus? Yeah, I'm multi-streaming. You know why I stopped last time? Is because my internet was bad. Now I have decent internet. So we're gonna put this stuff to use. So I'm gonna ask YouTube real quick, what do you want to learn first? Okay, YouTube gets the chance to vote. So if you want to vote, you got to come over to YouTube. I don't know how to do this on Streamlabs. What do you want to cover first? So we could cover mixing, we can cover music theory, we can cover just rhythms and beat making. I'll just say beat making technique. We could cover arrangement. Okay, so that's up to you guys. I'll let YouTube vote and then we'll see the results and then we'll get started. Hugh Kelly, what's up? Shout out to everybody. Is there a way to move the chat to the other side? Wait, layout editor. I might have found something. Give me a second here. Is there a way? Mini feed. If I hit this button, it's gonna change everything and I'm not gonna remember how to get it back. I probably should do this offline. But I want the chat on the left side, not the right side. But either way, we'll figure that out. All right, cool. All right, so we're just getting started for everybody who just hopped in. Mai is here, or May. Tyron is here, music theory. Oh, they're voting. Sampling, yeah, I'll consider that like beat technique. Hey, I have very little experience with DAWs. I've only used Audacity and started using BandLab, but want to move to an absolute beginner. Wait, sorry, the chat moved. But want to move to a more sophisticated DAW. How can an absolute beginner like me get started producing my own music? I would say start with FL Studio. It's for beat makers specifically. If you're more of a musician and you like to play by hand, maybe Ableton's better for you. But FL Studio has the most videos, it has the most content. It's just, there's a lot of reasons why. TJ's here, good night. Well, good, oh, you're what, 7:05? Yeah, 7 p.m.? It's evening, it's early evening over here, late afternoon. I think we need to learn how to make ear candy music is 90% instruments. You don't even hear it, it's all you feel. Yeah, that's more advanced. That might be a little over people's heads. Can we all just agree that Busy has changed the game for us producers and musicians? Hey, thank you. This is Javier. What's Busy? Wait, what? What's Busy? What are we doing today? We're taking a vote right now. So it looks like the poll voted for 31% mixing and 29% rhythms and beat making technique. So it looks like you guys want to cover mixing, which is interesting. All right, so what I'm gonna do is we're gonna mix, what's his name's record? Nippy Cray. So what I'm gonna do is download the multi-tracks. I just have to turn off this, oh wait, it's tied. It's tied between mixing and rhythms and beat making. How hilarious, oh now it's back to mixing. Let's start off with mixing, because mixing can apply to every DAW. I'm on a Mac, the piano rolls, I'm on Mac. The piano roll shortcut option scroll for velocity isn't working. Option scroll. I've never used that shortcut before. I've just never used it. I don't even know what that does. Sorry to tell you. Can we all, I'm reading old comments. Okay, so without further ado, real quick, I just got to download some multi-tracks. So I have to turn off my screen because it's a private document. So give me one sec and then we'll get started. So what we're going to do now is mix. Let me see, share. We're gonna mix Nippy Cray's record that he did for Keyshawn. We're gonna open it up in the DAW and I'm gonna show you how to mix a beat specifically. There's no vocals because we don't have the vocals back yet. So we're gonna download this and, oops. Wait, hold up y'all. Clicked the wrong tab. Oh, and I lost the link. Oh no, here it is. Okay, reverb, okay. Anybody else use Google Drive? I'm on Amazon now. I used to use all that stuff, but they let me down. We had so many people trying to download everything that it just broke our Google Drive. So this looks like it's taking a sweet old time to download. Oh no, never mind. But let me answer your questions in the meantime. Real quick, is it possible to send music to you for feedback every Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern time? We do song feedback live on YouTube. So we do that live on YouTube. Uncle Eric, 100. What's up, man? Slowly getting back into your world on this Twitch device. What's your background in music theory? I mean, we just muscled through. Actually, I had one college course on songwriting, but it confused me to death. And that's why I figured out the chord codes. That's actually how I figured it out. By going to a college level course, I realized how terrible they taught me. And then I created a new way of understanding music theory, which is based on chord codes, which is way better. You said, my friend is a professional guitarist. Can I record his guitar loops? Yes, we're taking on everybody. When I say this is a real record label, we're gonna have sound designers, mixing engineers, producers, artists, like everything. This is not just gonna be a couple producers at a time. This is going to be everybody's involved. Graphic designers, video editors. Wait, he gave me 3 downloads. Okay, so this must be a huge download. Oh, you can't see the screen. My fault. That's why you can't see the screen. Oops, my bad. You know, if you want to learn how to make beats and use FL's beginner, go back and watch games videos. Yeah, I need to update some of the beginner videos because I understand they're 5 years old. Give me one sec, y'all. Hold on one sec. All right, had to handle biz. So, okay, let's get it rocking. Without further ado, you're like, okay, game, we've been on for 15 minutes, get to it. Okay, so what we're gonna do is unzip these folders and we're gonna drag them in FL. So let's go to show folder. And this file is called thanks. So we're gonna create a new file and call it mixing practice. So this is a good idea. You want to stay organized. This is very disorganized for me. Like all this is actually very disorganized. Usually I have my downloads folder clear. So the first thing you want to do is organize your computer. And a lot of people don't know how to use a computer. So you want to learn how to use a computer. Like Control Shift N creates new folders. You got to learn that shortcut. That's just one of the many. So let's open these up. And then we'll drag all these into FL. What's happening? The whole show says, oh, thank you for hopping in. Eric says he's chilling. Okay, so we're gonna focus on mixing, so I'll go through it. So here's, so this download was so big, it separated it into different parts. So I have to take these out of the folder, put it into one mega folder. How many files is this? Holy crap. Okay, so we got all these sounds. I feel like there's gonna be duplicates. There's no way that there's this many tracks. What? There cannot be 50 tracks on this record. There's no way. I just don't believe this. But apparently there are. That's insane. Let me triple check. That looks like way too many tracks. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. Why don't I just count the rows? 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 21. No, wait. 20 rows of 3. That's 61 tracks. What the frick is this guy doing in his record? Okay, so he's 61 tracks, which is going to be half insane already. That's way too many tracks. So when you're recording, when you're making beats, consolidate stuff. Like, I know in EDM they have 100 tracks and stuff. There's no real reason to deliver 60 plus tracks. That's ridiculous. You need to group tracks together. Okay, so first rule as a producer, if you're gonna send off stuff like this, group your stuff together. Nobody wants to go through 80 tracks to figure out which sound is which. Your sound, your genre, try live instruments. Maybe that's why you're stuck. You're using too many software plugins. Try live instruments. Okay, so that's rule number one. When you send off, make sure you label everything and then consolidate. Nobody wants to go through 80,000 things to find the one thing. They just don't. Okay, so without complaining even more, let's drag this in. All 62 files. It's gonna be a fun mixing day with 62 files. But this is Nippy Cray's track that we picked for the Keyshawn record that we're gonna be putting out. And then you guys will have access to this download as well. So I should put this in Discord soon. After this stream, I'll put the link in Discord so everybody can have access. But you have to be on a team. The only way to see the link is to be on a team. Okay, so look at all these tracks. Way too many. So the first step, when you have, let's say you're mixing somebody else's record, you have to group stuff together. So this session is very disorganized. This is why a lot of people have mixing assistants, because the assistants organize these tracks to make them make sense. Okay, so there's way too many tracks. So what we're gonna do is just play the record. Oh, also in FL, it exports one unnecessary file. And you just got to be aware of this when you use FL. So it's, and because other DAWs don't understand what the heck it is. So you need to look for it. It's called the current file. So right here it says current, delete that because it's an extra file. I forget what current really does, but it just represents whatever current track you're on. And we also need to delete the master track when we're mixing so that it's not tripling up the volume. Okay, so this is the record. Now the first step is send everything to the mixer as its own individual thing. So we're gonna double click everything, all that green, we're gonna highlight, hit Control L, and it will automatically send it to the mixer and name it. Now again, in my opinion, this should have been organized way better, but it just is what it is. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is listen to the record, see where it goes, how it feels, and then we'll assign priority from here. So that's the first step. So I'm gonna mute my mic so he can get, his beat can be heard. Also, I forgot to mention one thing, turn up your headphones. It will force you to turn stuff down. So that's the first step. I'm gonna rewind this real quick because I forgot to mention that. So what I'm doing right now is listening through the track. My brain is gonna say, what is the actual priority of the track? And then I'm gonna turn up my headphones so that it sounds loud. And I'm gonna, because it sounds loud, I'm gonna turn stuff down. So the first step is actually turning stuff down in FL Studio because the faders are, usually stuff is way too loud. So I want to pause here, and if you heard all the sounds that we were just listening to, there's so many sounds. And then you heard when the vocals were like screaming loud, and then there was a synth that just came in out of nowhere. So that's why I'm turning stuff down. Also, it looks like he made a couple tracks that were duplicates. I couldn't really tell what the intent was. This is another portion of being the mixing engineer, is you don't know people's intent sometimes. So it says, replace Thanks for Chilling With Me bass. So I'm assuming he didn't want to use this bass, but what happened was he still exported it unmuted. So now it's showing up as a track, even though it shouldn't be here. So sometimes you have sounds that don't belong in the actual record and you need to kind of reverse engineer and kind of guess what they were trying to do. In on my day. Oh, thank you. 505, Coid 505. But this record is really hard. There's a couple sounds I didn't catch because I couldn't see them because there's 60 tracks. So I couldn't see them in time. There was like one sound that was like I forgot what it was. But what I'm doing is, okay, again, the task right now is listen to the record and turn your headphones up so that everything's louder than usual. It will force you to pull stuff down. And then what I'm also doing is if anything has like obvious mud where it's a lot of low end, like usually from 400 hertz down, I'm gonna use a high pass filter. I use Fab Filter Pro Q because it has a feature that I like called the tilt EQ. So that's why I'm doing that one specifically. You don't need that EQ. You can use any EQ that has a high pass filter. And what I'm doing is just cutting out the lows. of stuff that doesn't need to be there. Because when you have 60 tracks, all that low end builds up over time. The same way if I record in this microphone, it's very noisy. Like if I turn off this plugin, it's gonna be super noisy, watch. Well, not super duper noisy. But you hear all that extra grit and bullcrap? So if I recorded 10 tracks with all this background sound, it would just keep stacking on itself and it would become really loud. So what we need to do is get rid of all the lows that are adding up, all that kind of ghost frequency stuff, stuff that people can't hear. All right, one sec, gotta. Oh, this. Shout out to Max Novak. Out there being a beast. Okay, so let's continue. So I'm just letting people know the concept of what I'm doing right now. We're just listening and then prioritizing. How to get on record labels as an artist, join us on Discord. Thank you, thank you. And all you gotta do, if you wanna be a part of this, you gotta submit for the current song challenge, which is under the song submission, or the song submission. I forget what I called it. I wanna say it's song challenge tab. That's right in the team section of the Beat Battles. That's where you submit for the song challenge, because we have a female artist this week. Okay, so without me keep talking about it, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just listening, prioritizing, and having my headphone volume up. Bass line is kind of off. Track has so many that song has so many tracks. I was not expecting that many tracks on that song, but now it explains why it sounds so complex and good at the same time. So there were a lot of sounds that one, I'm unsure of this bass. I got to figure out, it sounds like it's pumping, so he must have had a sidechain set up on this bass. So let's listen in. Or he used an 808. Oh, that's the 808 itself, okay. Then it turns into like a funky bass, which is interesting. Okay, so that the bass is doing a lot. I thought it was a kick that was sidechaining a bass, and I thought it was off timing. Okay, so let's do this in chunks. So the first chunk, because it gets convoluted at a certain point where there's like 30 sounds happening at once. We don't want to be overwhelmed by too many sounds happening at once. I know people tell you to mix at the loudest part. In my opinion, if you're confused, it doesn't help any more than it does. So let's start with the first. Also, I didn't get the BPM, which is really important. So I need to figure out the BPM, and I deleted FL off of my phone. So how are we gonna get the BPM? Think for a second. I guess we could use Ableton real quick, because I don't wanna use FL because it will stretch the audio. So let me load up Ableton real quick. Tap the BPM. Now we don't have to be dead set. Let's tap it. One. This thing is lagging, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It keeps going up, what the heck? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Why is it going up? This can't be right. So it says 108. First it said 96. So I don't know what to believe on Ableton. But let's just say it's 108. To triple check, we're gonna set the metronome to 108. We're gonna turn it on. It should click with the track. So just because it's off doesn't mean it's not on rhythm though. Depends on how the thing was exported. So this would be a good idea to bring back that master track to figure out what BPM we're in. Cause that's an important piece of data when it comes to delays and when it comes to reverbs. You need to understand the BPM. So let's grab the master track real quick, find the BPM. So let's do the current track, solo, and I'm gonna let the metronome play. Oh, you know how to turn it off. Give me a sec. 18, where's 18? So if we're on BPM, this should match up. Is this a video live? Yes. We're on YouTube right now, but I'm streaming to every platform. So this isn't 108. It could be, but it's not on beat. So if you struggle, here's what you do. We're gonna start on an obvious downbeat, which is right here. You. Okay, so there's even a marker here, a time marker, that little yellow thing. We're gonna start there, figure out the BPM here. Oh, you know what? This might be set to auto. No, it's set to resample. So I'm taking a cue from the hi-hats too. 298 BPM. Hold on, y'all. The hardest part is finding the BPM and the BPM. My ear is saying 115. That, okay, so if it's off beat like that, then it means that the song probably didn't start on the right measure or didn't drop. So we need to find a section where it's. Here's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so if it's confusing you, just like it's confusing me, we're gonna take an obvious transient, which is right there. Drag it all the way to the left. We're gonna measure from here. I don't know if he did tempo automation either, because he has a whole bunch of time markers everywhere. What BPM is this freaking record? Holy crap. Tap, 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 tap. It says 108. Look, this is blowing my mind. This thing is moving, it has a moving BPM. What the freak? So another random problem you may come into an issue with if the BPM is not consistent. 110, you think? I wasn't hearing 110. I heard 108. Regardless of what BPM, it's not lining up. Oh, there it is. Shout out to freaking Uncle Eric with the 110. It's a little off though, but yeah, okay, 110. Good looks. I was two off. I don't know, that detect feature, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I like to use my ear a lot more. Okay, we found it. Good looks. Whew. That's why it's so important to put the metadata in the information so people know what the heck is going on. Like when people send you a loop and they don't tell you the key, good luck. Or the BPM, and then they let it trail off for 20 extra bars and you're like, okay, what BPM are we at? One of the cardinal sins. Okay, without further ado, now we know the BPM's around 110 or 110. Thanks to Eric, appreciate that. Yeah, because I see all these time markers. That means he time warped, probably using a new time or Melodyne or something. There's a whole bunch of time markers on this audio. Good looks. That would have drove me insane if I didn't get the BPM. I was that close to cursing him out. Okay, so there we go. Thank you for that. So what we're going to do now is find an empty track, mixer channel, I'll say, and then we're going to call this mix bus. We're going to group all these sounds. We're going to hit control, left click, and highlight all of the sounds in the song. Okay, and we're going to left click and drag in FL Studio. And we're going to right click the up arrow and go to route to this track only. Pardon me. So most people, they mix straight into the master in FL Studio. That's fine to some degree, but you can't control a lot of stuff when it comes to mastering, especially if you mix everything at the mastering stage. So we're going to create something called a mix bus. This is like a foreign concept for people in hip hop. We're so used to just slamming everything through the master because we hand our stuff off to other people anyway to mix. Plugin used to detect BPM. I didn't use a plugin. I just tapped the BPM. I didn't use a plugin. You just right click and go to tap BPM, but it wasn't working regardless. I was trying to use my FL Studio mobile. I usually tap the screen on that. Chat for the win, for real. Okay, so now we have everything organized to a degree. It seems like the priority is the drums and the bass. Okay, so now we have the BPM, now we can actually work. So I like to work in chunks. I don't like to be overwhelmed with everything all at once. So let's take the first 8 bars. I know people tell you to mix the loudest part first. We don't have vocals yet, so it's kind of pointless to me to mix the loudest part, especially when it's this many tracks. So I'm gonna start with the first 8 bars. And I'm gonna look at this mix bus and I wanna stay around negative 12-ish. I know you can go up to 0 and pass 0, but a lot of these plugins, if you're clipping going into the plugin, it actually makes the sound completely different. Like if you send a square wave through an exciter, it sounds different than a sine wave. So I know people tell you can clip for days and everything like that, but it changes the way these plugins work. Okay, so you just have to be really cognizant. The plugins don't act the same way as the DAW. So I know you're hearing that a lot with people telling you, yo, it's cool to clip. Okay, you clip going through a freaking compressor and see what happens. Okay, so meaning a certain style compressor. Okay, so this is negative 15. We're averaging negative 15-ish. Now, some people believe in mixing into a compressor. Here's where the glue, what's up, Jamel? Here's where the glue comes into play. I'm pretty good, Rexon. Thank you for asking me. So we're gonna mix into what's called a bus compressor. And my analog setup has it's called a Dione from West Audio. It mimics the SSLG compressor, which is this compressor that you'll see. The only thing is this doesn't have, oh yeah, it does. So we're gonna set this attack. I like mine at 30, and I like my release at 100 milliseconds, which is 0.1 seconds. And I like my ratio at 4:1. So all we're doing right now is just making this needle subtly crank to the right. That's it. Try not to go beyond 4. Once you go beyond 4, you're doing too much. Now the record isn't even like into the loudest part, so we're probably gonna have to pull back these settings eventually. But let's just pull down the threshold. And also I know I'm going a little fast here, but there's something called a sidechain high pass. So what we're gonna do is tell the compressor to not listen to anything below a certain frequency. This way the kicks don't get squashed to death when they hit. but we'll be compressing everything else. So we're gonna compress everything above 150 hertz, which is basically everything above the kick. So if your plugin doesn't have that feature for a bus compressor, I wouldn't really buy it. You need that sidechain control, in my opinion. Okay, so I'm just setting this. Let me at least let the drums come in. So I'm only setting the compressor at the loud parts, and then I'm gonna go back to that first eight bars. Okay, so you can see I'm taking out almost 3 to 4 dB, which is a lot. So let's pull the threshold up so it doesn't react so much. Okay, so remember that compressor is really just to think of it like auto-tune for volume. Think of it that way. Too much auto-tune is like, dang, that sounds terrible, but a little bit of auto-tune sounds decent. That's how I think about compression. VNiz is on Twitch. I could stream the Beat Battle to Twitch. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, we can multi-stream now. We'll stream Facebook, Twitch, Trillis. You know what made me also realize we could multi-stream was because I got rid of one of my social media management tools, which posted to Facebook and Twitter all the memes that I would do, and I would have them like scheduled out weeks in advance. Then I realized the social medias don't like that when you have your stuff coming from like one of those programs. So I post manually now. And then me turning that off made me realize that I had Twitch and that I had, and that Facebook needed more content. So that's why I'm live streaming on the different platforms right now. Shout out to everybody on Facebook and Twitch. Bro, you're one of the most down-to-earth, humble person who is providing a lot of knowledge on the internet for free. Lots of respect to you. Thank you, Astrobix. I try to humble myself so I don't get humiliated by the universe. Could a multi-band compressor work for a sidechain input? I wouldn't do it that way because, no. I think you're asking, I think you're referring to the streaky mastering technique where he did the multi-band compressor and then he did the sidechain input. I think that's what you're referring to. To control the lows, but no, I don't like to do that on my, not on this track. Okay, so now we have that. Pianist prodigy. If you're a piano player, we need sound designers. We need people who can play musical loops. That's what this record label thing is all about. So come join us on Discord. Hop in the economy. Come join us. He said he just got fired. Any decent paying jobs you guys know about? Sound designer. You know how many loops we need? We need an insane amount of loops. Now don't expect money right away. That's the biggest problem people have. They expect money right now or else they don't do anything. And that's people's biggest mistake, really. That's why you don't have opportunities. You gotta sow seeds before you want the harvest. Okay. So we have the mix bus. Okay, so now we have to think of any creative stuff we wanna do. Right now, I don't hear anything creatively. So let me turn off my mic because it adds so much noise. Okay, so the power here is going to be in creating groups. So what I'm going to do now, and here's where it's going to get a little tedious for me because now I have to go through every sound. But we're going to create what's called an instruments bus and then an instruments effects bus. Okay, or send, or you know, return track. Okay, so let's do this. Okay, and now what I need to do is group all the instruments into the pink one, and then I'm gonna send them as an additional signal to the blue one or the purple one. So I'll left click here, that's a send. We're not routing directly to, we're sending a duplicate of that track somewhere else, and then just pull the volume back. And what I'm gonna do on this instruments effects track is create a unique instruments effects thing, like moving filters, delays, reverbs, anything to make it sound like a creative effect. And then we'll have all the instruments go through that as a second processing tool to give it a little more custom feel to it. Jamel makes loops. There we go. Yeah, so this whole record label thing, just join us on Discord. I think I have the Discord on the screen, I think. Let me triple check though. Oh yeah, busyworksbeats.com. /Discord. That's where we're all at. There's 11,000 people in there. It's a producer city. You can collab in there. You can get song feedback in there. You can live stream in the Discord. You can be a part of this record label stuff where we're producing for artists. You could get free downloads. There's 1,000 things. There's a free mixing and mastering course in there. Assassin for a cheaper replacement for the I missed something. Do I know about Looperman? Yeah, but it's kind of, I don't know the quality though. Discord's right on the screen. No, we rate beats on Fridays at 9 p.m. Eastern time. Does it cost to enter the beat battle? No. I try not to be the beat battle league that is like, how to win $500 tonight at the beat battle. Come on down. And yeah, no, just corny. We do it because we are here for the blood sport of beat battling. The beat battle league. We're going to turn it into the NBA of beat battles. Okay, I don't want to go too sidetracked. Just want to answer your questions. When you automate in FL, do you highlight the whole beat or just a section you want to automate? That question is framed really weird. I know what your question is. My fault. I thought you were saying something else. Yeah, I make sure it's the whole beat because what happens with automation in FL Studio is that it just reads whatever the last value was. So if you start the song off and the last value was 100, it's going to start off the song on 100. And then when the automation kicks in at 0, it's going to turn off. So you got to tell it what to be the whole entire track or else it just reads the last value. So yeah, that was a more advanced question. How to record real instruments to create loops? You need a microphone? I'll do that one day. Not right now though. I don't want to get too sidetracked. Your questions are all over the place. How do you keep yourself motivated when starting? You gotta introduce unknowns. Unknowns are what keep you motivated and excited. What don't you know? Gotta pay with your soul. Yeah, DJ Rob Snow's like, I'm 8 lives in. I'm on my 9th live. I was just thinking about it. I saw something on TikTok about fast food. I mean, just get your money, you know what I mean? However you can. I don't talk down on jobs. You know, everybody can't be a content creator. I mean, they can if they have a job and content creator, but everybody can't be in the office. Everybody can't be on the ground level. You know, it has to be a balance of all these jobs and positions. Okay, without further ado, we're getting too sidetracked. Okay, so we're gonna group the instruments. So in FL, you hit Alt left or Alt right to move it around in the mixer. So I'm gonna consider the vocals an instrument, but we're gonna hit Alt right to pull them to the right. So I'm separating the sounds from the rest of the sounds. That's what I'm doing right now. And I'm only doing it visually. Whatever is showing up green, I'm moving it to the right. So I think we have everything. This is called crackles. I wouldn't consider that an instrument. But it's important that you group things visually, in my opinion. I think this is like a group. I can't tell. It's like a sound effect. Okay, so that's not an instrument. Okay, so now we have these to the right. We're gonna highlight them. Hit control, left click and highlight, then right click and route these to this track only. So now all those sounds are in this one thing called an instruments track. And what I'm gonna do with this instruments track is level everything. Cause right now everything seems like it's low volume. But when you start combining sounds, you start to realize how loud they actually are together. And you don't want your instruments to be super loud because then you're not going to be able to hear your drums and everything. So right now they're sitting at negative 19 to negative 14 dB, which is pretty loud as a group. So let's pull them down with Fruity Balance. This is basically just dB. We're just going to pull them down. So we're pulling them down as a group. You can still hear them, but they're just not eating up all that space. Have I ever worked fast food? No, but I mean, I've worked in a college, what is that place called? Like a grill place. So technically I've worked in food, definitely, in 2 different places in college. And vocals at 83, the instrumentals at 153. You could time stretch it, if anything. You talking about this track or the other one? How do you stop having your songs sound like loops? You gotta introduce variations. If everything sounds like a loop, that means it's doing the same thing. You gotta change stuff up. That's why it sounds like it's looping. Make your drum patterns longer. Instead of just like 2 bars, make them 4 bars and change up the kicks along the way. All right, so now we have all the instruments. We're gonna run them through a compressor. And this compressor is not to pull out the detail. It's really just to keep everything stable so it's not jumping around. Because the number one thing when you're dealing with trap and R&B and stuff, especially with modern stuff, is that, where is it at? We're gonna use our compressor. Is that stuff just is, okay. Just like you can have too many instruments in a track, you can have too much movement in a track. So if everything's just trying to be the center of attention and moving all over the place, it gets confusing to the ear. So we're gonna tame these instruments with a compressor. In college, true. So I'm gonna go 4-to-1 ratio here. I'm gonna type it in, 4-to-1 ratio. And then just pull down the threshold for the compressor. So again, the goal of this compressor on the instruments is just keep stuff stable so it's not eating up a bunch of headroom. I would say it's to pull out the transients, but it's really just to keep stuff locked in and stable. We can always up the gain and figure that out later. Okay, so all we really had outside of that is the bass. So we have to determine the tone of the bass. So I'm gonna go to a different section of the song. And then I'm gonna get a little creative with the bass. This is just my style. Don't copy this exactly. This is the creative part of mixing. So one of the things about mixing is that people can't hear it when it's on phone speakers. So what we're gonna do, and I should be mixing over monitors, it's just that in order to talk and do this at the same time, it requires too much back and forth. So I have to mix over headphones for now. But to polish this mix, I would mix over the monitors. It gives you a different perspective. Yeah, so what we're gonna do with the bass is we're gonna add harmonics. So everybody has a different style of harmonics. Okay, you can do saturation, you could do compression, you could do distortion. Those are all different styles of harmonics. You could do tape saturation, which is like a huge thing that people are doing right now. Hold on 1 second, I gotta listen to this thing. Give me 1 second, I'm gonna play the track. Give me a sec, y'all. Talking to my baby girl. Sorry, I mean, it's amazing having somebody that actually is into you. Hopefully you guys get that feeling too. Okay, so without further ado, shout out to my baby girl, Nicole Nix at NicoleNix.com. She does vocal tags and she sells beats and she's a crazy producer. Okay, so without further ado, what was I talking about? The bass. So the bass is where people can't hear it on their phones. What you could do is duplicate the bass and then saturate the duplicate of the bass to keep the main one intact, or you could just add all the saturation directly on the bass. So you could do either way. It depends on how much low end that you lose. Building a fan base Join us on Discord. That's where you'll make friends a lot faster than making content and stuff. I didn't hear the Weeknd's new album. You don't have to go to school for music. I wouldn't waste a lot of money on music school because the schools hire me to teach their students. So just don't waste your, unless you're learning like patch bay and like the electronics and the physics behind music, I would not spend a lot of money on learning music at all. That's just my take on it as a producer. But I learned the hard way. So, I mean, I didn't go the traditional route. But we have training. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. There's a bunch of free courses for you there. Actually, no, it's premium.busyworksbeats.com. That's how you get to the free courses. There was a question in here and I missed it. I forgot where I was. I'm all about the fuel. Mm-hmm. Any tips on building a fan base? Join our Discord. The link's on the screen. How long would you say it took for you to be confident in using FL? When you're learning anything, you have to define all the words that you don't understand, all the concepts you don't understand. I literally have a notebook upstairs. I'm learning how to code and I'm learning new things about crypto and everything. I have a notebook full of like 100 words that I say I don't know. What's a name server? What's a name base? What's syntax? You know, what does .cpp mean? Everything that I don't understand, I write it down in this notebook. And you have to define the words. If you don't define words, you're not going to understand anything. So that's the first step that you have to do. And most people just don't want to take the time to define things. Like, what is a kick? What's a snare? What's a hi-hat? What's a low frequency? What's mid? What's low mid? What's a bass frequency? You have to define all those words for yourself. Just get a big old notebook, a good old fashioned notebook, line by line. Every word you don't know, write it down and define it. Like, what's phase? Stuff like that. So with this bass, I'm gonna run it through. It's called Thermionic Culture Vulture. And what I'm gonna do here is use the mix knob and then crank it up so that we can hear the saturation, and then I'm gonna turn the effects down. So whenever you can't hear an effect, turn it up, just like I did with my headphones in the beginning of this mix, and then you could turn it back. So I'm gonna crank this drive knob. Now it's making the bass louder. I hear it goes, you hear that buzz? Now I would be able to feel it if I have my speakers on, but I don't. I like it, but the thing is, it's loud, so I need to pull back the output level. The output meaning the volume. I also want this bass to have some type of stereo width to it. So a cool thing you could do is either add a chorus plugin to your bass, or you could do like a very, very small amount of reverb. Okay, so that is something that a lot of people don't know. So let's do micro shift. Now there's 1,000 plugins. I'm trying to think, what did I do at the one time? Was it chorus or was it? I think it was a little bit of reverb actually to widen out the 808. So what we're gonna do is just pull it. Let me turn this up so you can really hear. Now I'm exaggerating this so you guys can hear. Can you talk more about effects, like what they do? Sure. So saturation, this is just one form of it. Saturation basically creates what are called harmonics. So you hear my low voice, it's like a low male voice. I have to show you what harmonics are. So thank you for your questions and feel free to, you know, ask stuff like that. That way I can elaborate. Let's pull this up. Wait, where'd he go? It just disappeared on me, hold up. Wave candy, okay, let's turn this up. Switches to spectrum mode. Okay, so you see how my voice is, okay, well, first I have to show you what a sine wave looks like. Okay, so we have a good old lesson. So this is physics right here. We're talking about frequencies and harmonics. So when I play a sine wave, which is just it's called the fundamental frequency. It's the mother of all frequencies, is a sine wave. So I'm gonna turn off my mic so you can hear it. But basically when the sine wave plays, it's one horizontal line. So you see how on the screen it shows that horizontal line? Okay, that's a sine wave. It's a very pure form of sound because it's only one frequency. But when we speak, we don't speak in only one frequency. We might be tuned to a certain frequency, but we don't speak in one frequency. So what you have to look for with vocals is something called, or any sound, called a fundamental frequency. So if you like make this, what do you call this? This graph freeze. I forget how to make this freeze. Give me a second, yo. Forgetting all the shortcuts. So basically all these little hills that you see are harmonics. Am I too loud? Oh, you're talking about the sine wave? I probably could have played a lower tone. Okay, and that's actually, I'll get to it. I don't want to go too far. But anyway, you see all these little hills that my voice is creating? These are called harmonics. So if you look at the bottom, I'll just kind of, I'll hold a note for a second. Okay, you see that bottom hill right there? Wait, let's do it again, my screen. Okay, you see how that bottom hill, and then there was another hill, and then more and more hills? Those hills are called harmonics. The hills have harmonics. And instead of the hills have teacher jokes? No? So long story short, in physics, I just clicked on something by accident, hold up. So long story short, in physics, let's say a sine wave is at 60 hertz. Harmonics are just multiples of that frequency. Now we can get into odd harmonics and distorted harmonics and all that, but there's something called a harmonic series. So basically, when you start at 60 hertz, the second harmonic is 2 times 60. So 2 times 60 is 120. Then the third harmonic would be 3 times 60, which is 180. And the fourth harmonic is 4 times 60, 240, and on and on and on and on and on. So our voice is not just one frequency, it's multiple frequencies. Whereas this bass is not multiple frequencies. It is multiple frequencies, but it doesn't have enough frequency content to be heard on a phone. So if we just look at the graph for this bass, for example, let's do Q, and let's look at the graph. So it has harmonics, but they're not like, they're not really loud enough, really. So one thing we could do is either exaggerate it with more harmonics so that it becomes louder. So here's what it looks like with the, see that section of the high mids got louder. Okay, so that's with the saturation, here's without. See, this hill is fading down a lot quicker. So it's harder to hear when there's not enough high frequency information to hear. Okay, doctor for an ear test. shoot, remember in school, I don't know how old you guys are, but back in my day, they used to beep something in your right ear, something in your left ear, and you had to tell them if you hear it in your right ear, if you hear it in your left ear, it was a hearing test. Now the problem was kids who were a little sluggish in school, they put it on the left ear, part was put on the right ear. So every time the teacher would say, do you hear it in your left ear? They would raise their right hand. It was just a mess. What plugin have you used to get that bass? I didn't make this beat, we're mixing the beat. Okay, so that's the explanation of harmonics. If the phone can't hear anything below, let's say 200 hertz, then you need to make the bass be able to be heard and everything above 200 hertz. And the way you do that is either exaggerate the harmonics or pull up using the compressor, the low mids to high mids. So there's a lot of ways you can do it. I'm gonna do it with adding more saturation because I want the bass to have a bite to it. Switch this from overdrive mode back to normal. So I just added a little bit of harmonics. Remember, the mix level blends the original sound with the affected sound, so it creates this new thing. Okay, so let's turn on our widening effect. The only thing I don't like about the bass is that delay, but again, I didn't pick the record. We're gonna blame Keyshawn. So what happens is, so you see how I widen the bass? My bad. It's now in our left and the right ear. The OS OS says, man, I bought your chord magic, beat magic, and music theory in a day. I'm looking forward to learn. Yeah, those are people, I don't want to go on so many diatribes, but a lot of people, they think they know everything, and that's why they're not moving forward. Sometimes you do have to revisit the basics to get to the next level. It really is that intense when it comes to music production. You have to keep revisiting the fundamentals over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. There's still things about phase that I don't understand. So, I mean, there's... So just always remember you don't know everything. That will always keep you ready to learn. Okay, so let's... So the thing about this bass is it's wobbling all up and down. So I want to tame this bass. I'm going to use a limiter to tame it. Now we're pulling down the threshold and the output ceiling at the same time using Waves L2. So this is just going to keep it stable. Now I'm going to use the limiter before the wider effect. Also, I'm going to get rid of any plugins that we don't need. Okay, so there's a lot going on. So let's go back to our method, which is 8 bars at a time. So we covered the first 8 bars. Let's focus on the second 8 bars. And if there's any concept that I talk about or plugin, I'll slow it down and explain what's going on. I know I sped through these, but it's more of a creative thing. So that's what the saturator is doing. It creates those harmonics so that the bass can be heard. I'm still going to revisit the bass. The limiter is just making sure the bass isn't so wobbly, you know, it's just doing a whole bunch of stuff. So we're trying to contain it. Instead of making it do this, we want it to just be like this. It still wobbles, but it's not as wobbly like that, going up and down in volume like that. Okay, so that's why we're using that limiter slash compressor to tame it a little bit. Sorry, it's hard to read the context of your questions, so hold the questions for a second, but if there's a concept you want me to focus on, I'll definitely focus on it. And then the micro shift takes a mono sound or a one directional sound and it duplicates it out and it makes it have a body to it, a width to it. So that's why I use that plugin. So hopefully we're on the same track. Okay, so the beat's pretty bare. So what I'm going to do for this part is group all the other instruments that I didn't grab before. So I'm going to turn off my mic because it's so loud. Right, so again, during that section, I was just trying to find the sounds that were deemed instruments, because remember, this session didn't come in really organized. It was just a bunch of tracks. So what I did was I am organizing the sounds over time. So I'm going to take all these sounds that we just grabbed from the vocal all the way to here. And I keep my everything like in one section, so it's easy to see. And then we're just going to right click and route them to that instruments track. So now they're going to go through the compressor to be all going through the same plugins at the same time. Ruben says, Cutso says, I have to join premium to learn more, but I like to ask how much per month because I'm in South Africa. It's free courses on our premium. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. There's free courses. There's a piano melody course, a mastering course for free, a UK drill course for free. I think we have a trap melody course for free. There's a lot of free courses on there. So just start there. Then you can work your way up. The harmonics don't distribute the other elements in the mix. The harmonics don't distribute the other elements in the mix. Oh, I read that wrong. Disturb. Okay, my fault. The harmonics don't disturb the other elements. Usually, Trying to think of an analogy. So give me 3 seconds to think about this. Imagine a highway with cars. And you have a highway where everybody's going 2 miles an hour. And then you have a highway where everybody's going 300 miles an hour. Or like, you know, different ranges from 150 to 300. It's a lot easier to lane change when you're going 150 to 300 because the odds and the chances of somebody going your exact speed are so small that you could just lane change easily. But if everybody's going 2 miles an hour, in order to lane change, you're gonna get stuck in traffic. Everybody's trying to turn the lanes and there's no room. So that's the difference between low frequencies and high frequencies, is that low frequencies have a lot less room to deal with. So there's a lot more clashing because they move slower. Whereas higher frequencies, they move so fast that there's more time space to not clash. So hopefully that made sense. So when you're adding harmonics and stuff like this, there's less clashing going on. Even if there is clashing in high frequencies, it doesn't sound as bad as low frequency clashing. Low frequency clashing sounds like a wobble, like it's like a wobble. Whereas higher frequency stuff sounds like a washy sound. Okay, so what headphones do I wear? These aren't the greatest for mixing, but these are Sennheiser HD 600s. I really prefer monitors. It's just the way to do videos is I would have to do a bunch of stuff to make that work, and it just is not the easiest workflow. Okay, because it would feed back into the mic, and then the mic would feed into the speakers, and then it would create this really loud sound, and it'd be very hard to talk to you guys. Okay. So now we have the instruments. What you can do, instead of using individual fab filters on each individual instrument, you could put it on the group track so that everything just automatically gets a high pass filter. And that's what I'm going to do so that we can preserve resources, because again, when you have 64 plugins loaded up, your session can get heavy really easy. So I'm taking off any individual high pass filters and I'm putting it onto the group. And let's cut out everything below, let's say 80. But if something needs to be cut off in particular, I'll go to that channel and cut it up. So anything from like 100 and below, we really don't need in the instruments. So I mentioned this instruments effects tab. So let's focus on this. So what I'm gonna do so that you can listen like more comfortably is I'll turn my microphone down, as long as you guys don't care. I'll turn my microphone down so that you can turn your headphones up to hear these effects, because all the instruments are super quiet and my voice is super loud. So you said, we'll get into like the nitty gritty in a second. I just don't want to go on a side tangent. Okay, about the threshold and the attack and all that. So let's pull this down. And now we need to add effects. Now I can't even hear myself. We need to add effects to the instruments. So we have to decide what kind of effect do we want on the instruments. Since we're in parallel, we can do a lot of weird stuff and get away with it basically. So let's load up CLA effects. I'm doing this one because I like their exaggerated effect sound. So now all the instruments are getting this. Let me crank these up so we can hear. So it's just adding like a subtle detail. Also another one, this may crash the DAW, so let me save first. Let's load up Pan Man. Here's the technique I learned in one of our sample videos, which was not only do I do a parallel chain, but I make the chain, then make the parallel go left and right, so it's separated from the original. So anyway, you'll see in a second. So let's make it go left and right on step mode. So you hear it panning left and right. Now we can go through these effects. And you can hear the affected sound moving around, but the original sound's not moving. Okay, so we could do reverb, we could do, you can really get weird on this one. You could do chorus. We could do filter modulations. Just go to premium. Is there a way to chat everybody on here? I don't know if that's possible. But if you're on Twitch, shout out to you guys. LP6. Are you talking about the whole show says get the Kali Audio LP6.5s. Mixing on headphones, in theory, technically, there's not enough stereo spread because you're only hearing like your left ear, right ear, whereas in reality, well, also try the plug. There's so much stuff to talk about. I don't want to get too deep into it. But there's a plugin that emulates a real space using headphones, and it gave us a pretty decent mix when we used this by immersive audio. So I'm going to type this into YouTube. What was I going to type into YouTube? I forgot. Somebody help me. The freak was I talking about? Hold up. Lost my train of thought. I was going to type something to you and I completely forgot. Oh, the website. Okay. So it's my fault. My brain stuttered for like 3 seconds. So go to the free course. Just to show you what the website looks like so people don't think I'm just catfishing out here. It's premium.busyworksbeats.com. Okay. And here's what it looks like. You can get, so we have two new actually we have a new premium called Premium Deluxe, which is all of our courses in one. We've never done this before. It's $50 a month, but that's all of our courses. Like every single course we've ever made. Then we have premium, which is just like if you're trying to sharpen your skills, that's $19 a month. All the courses is $50 a month. It's called Premium Deluxe. We just launched that. But here's some free courses called Trap Series. We have the Melody Series. We have the Sample Series, the Piano Melodies, Trap Melodies, UK Drill, and a mastering course for free, and a beat battle course for free. Okay, so you get all those just for hopping in with us. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Okay, so that's where you get them from. Okay, so let's go to instruments. So I like this pan technique because then we could hear the affected signal separate from the original. So it creates this unique sound. It's subtle, but let's keep going through effects. So now the affected one is moving, remember? Okay, we can tuck it down so it doesn't have to be that exaggerated. I was just exaggerating. So it just adds an extra little thing. It's probably super subtle, but it adds like an extra thing to your instruments to make them lively. Okay, so we pretty much have accounted for most of the sounds. Now I'm going to create another group here. So notice how I'm organizing everything. Let's create another group called, let's call it like percussion. I'm going to separate this from drums because the drums may need a different process. So now we need to find all our percussion. So I'm going to hit Alt Left to move this to the left side of all the instruments. And let's see. See, there's a percussion loop in here. Here it is. We're gonna hit Alt Right to move it around. So I like to put all my stuff next to the groups and then right click, route to this track only. So now I can keep track of all the percussion in the track. And in this, I'll call the crackles a percussion, even though it's not technically, but it's part of the drum sound. So again, hit Alt Right to move it. And then right click and route to that track. My head might be in the way, sorry. Right click the up arrow, route to that track. So we're going over mixing. If you just hopped in, the YouTube crowd voted how to mix your beats first. Then we're going to get into beat, rhythm, or arrangement next. It's up to you. But they voted they wanted to learn mixing first. So let's do that. So now we're going to do 8 bars at a time. We're on the third eight bar count. So now what you theoretically should be able to do is turn off the groups that are marked in pink, and you should only hear the new items. And this lets me know I didn't group stuff right. If I'm hearing music, that means I didn't group something in the instruments track properly. So, which I didn't, I forgot to count for those. So let's route those. Okay, so that's music. Let's group that with the sound. So as a remixer, you guys will have access to all these multi-tracks at the end of the stream. Just join us on Discord and I'll upload it. Once we're done this stream. And basically what you can do is, like, this section sounds super dope. Like, imagine remixing this, rearranging it. So we're gonna have a remix contest too. That boom, boom, that sound. Also, I missed the vocal somewhere. Okay, I missed the vocal and I missed that loud pad thing that came in. So this is why organizing your sounds is so important. This track is so fire. Shout out to Nippy Cray, he went in on this one. I can't wait to hear what Keyshawn does to this. This is the record label track, by the way, for everybody who just joined in. We're creating our own record label in the Discord. And these are the, this is the production that you guys get to play with. So there's another sound I'm missing. It's going like, I can't find it though. So we have the percussion. I'm missing a percussion. Here it is. So the snare, oh, there it is. I see the instrument. I found it. It's right here. Okay, so it's those small little tiny sounds. We're gonna group that with instruments. Anything that's tonal and has chords or notes. Okay, so that, so again, in theory, if everything's routed properly, you should be able to turn off the groups and only hear the new sounds. So that lets you know if you're doing your routing properly. What's up, McKing? Just bought the Beyer Dynamic DT770s, 80 ohm and the 110 ohm. I forgot the other ohm. With Weiss plugin, I'm happy to have it. The Weiss plugin, once you understand what's going on, they're really good. Probably my favorite plugins for mixing. How do you know which course? Oh, my bad. I'm reading the chat and I was reading the old chat because my screen was frozen. My fault. The whole show says they're monitors that are actually pretty good price and have a very high quality. Okay. Shout out to you. Giovanni says, I've learned a lot from your tutorials on FL Studio while using Ableton. Not a lot of producers on YouTube use Ableton besides Kenny Beats and Reed, Stefan, I guess, at least that I've found. We could use Ableton. This is when I do Ableton stuff is that nobody watches it. So it's like, what's the point of doing Ableton stuff if nobody's going to support it? Okay, so that's why I don't do more Ableton stuff. Okay, so all I hear is the snare, which is good. Now the snare seems to have a reverb on it built into the actual sound. So we can't undo reverb. There's a little shaker thing I missed. So we're gonna group that with the percussion. So I'm gonna move the snare to the left just so it's out of the way. And I'm gonna move it right next to that bass. Okay, so so far our routing is good. So let's do 26 to 32 bars. 24 to 32 bars. It's 8 bars. There's like a drum loop that happened. Okay, so let's slide that to the left. I did not even hear these when we were listening back. There's so many sounds in this track, you guys, freak. Whew. So if you are gonna send multi-tracks, again, one of the biggest headaches is all the little stuff like organizing sounds, taking out breaths from a vocal recording, lining up vocals, like that's the stuff that is not the glamour side of mixing. So right here at the end, everything comes in. It's like 1,000 sounds. So I'm gonna organize, I'm gonna turn off my mic, but all I'm doing is just grouping sounds right now. Wow. So hopefully you guys can see this is, there's so many instruments in this track. I didn't realize there was this many sounds in here. But the easiest way to separate is tonal stuff from atonal stuff or non-tonal stuff. Stuff that doesn't make a frequency, like a key, like a note. So, whew, there's so many sounds in here I just did not fathom. So I'm going to put all the non-tonal stuff to the left, all the tonal stuff on the right for now. Track's really good. So again, what I'm doing is to help identify is I'm muting the grouped sounds. So all the percussion's grouped right now and all the instruments are grouped to a degree. And by me muting the group, I can now hear the stuff that I missed. And that's what I'm accounting for now. Yeah, a lot of small things definitely add up. There's so many tracks, I just did not even, I think we have a couple left. Okay, so now I'm going to use some common sense. Some of these tracks are labeled like sine leads. So a sine lead is probably going to be a tonal thing. This says bass. Shout out to all the people who are subscribing. Appreciate you guys. So I'm reading the name. I don't know why my head's turned sideways because I'm reading it horizontally. So I don't know why my head's sideways. So bells is probably going to be a tonal sound. This is just makes more sense than to try and find exactly. It says lyrics. Wait, hold up. Where'd the other sound go? So I'm reading in the top left. It you can read the text, the metadata. Oh, I just lost the bell track. Where'd it go? Here it is. Bells. So I'm hitting Control Shift to select multiple tracks. Deep harp is probably going to be tonal. Herbie keys again, probably going to be a tonal thing. Lead silly. Ocean wind brass is probably a tonal sound. Plucking sounds tonal to me. Sine leads for sure. Vocal reverb, that's off, so it doesn't matter. And I think that's it. So all those tracks, even though we might not have heard them yet, I'm just gonna call them instruments. So we're gonna grab all these sounds. Look how many instruments there are. My guy has 30 instruments in this track. Freaking orchestra. Okay, so we're gonna right click and route to that track, route to this track only. So now we should only hear percussion and drums in the whole track, if I did everything right, and bass. So let's open it back up. Okay, so now I'm gonna turn everything on except the instruments. So we should only hear the percussion and the bass. So this is just a triple check to make sure you got everything. See how long that took? And that's just organizing. ATL Terminus, mix and master his song and produce that. Yeah, once I saw 60 tracks, I was like, what are we doing? Can you hear me properly? You said wrong, blah. Wrong with this audio or wrong with what happened? What are we doing? What happened to the audio? Maybe it chopped out for a second. Did we lose the internet? Happens. Looks like we're back. So sorry, whatever happened on YouTube, I can't tell, but it looks like the audio is internet. Good. Okay. If you hear crackles, that's the sample that he used in the record. So I'm gonna group. Trying to debate. I guess percussion I'm going to consider more lightweight, whereas drums are a little more heavy. So let's create like a drums bus. Let's make this like blue. Yeah. This is a crazy song. A thousand things you could do with this record. What's up? Tender sounds. Don't get me to singing. It's gonna be my song next, Keyshawn. Okay. So I'm gonna group all these sounds to the drums group, even though these probably aren't drums. But just trying to save time. Okay, so now we have everything routed. That is the hardest part. Whew. Okay, so I showed you the instruments effects. So let's turn off the drums, and now we can only hear the instruments. And I'm gonna group the bass. Actually, I'm just gonna turn the bass off. So I'm mixing top down because I like detail first before I like the thump of a record. So again, the instruments are all coming into this one track. We're gonna send it to the instruments effects. Just adds that ear candy layer to it. And you can get creative. I know it's a little advanced because I would have to really exaggerate this for you to understand, but I'm using a high pass filter so that we're not creating too much harmonic content. And then I'm gonna tilt some of the highs so that they don't get in the way. We're gonna make it dynamic. So if it gets too loud, it basically just adds like it turns the highs down. So we're gonna focus the instruments from about 400 to 4,000 hertz. Severed sounds, welcome back to the squad. I don't have a cool name for it, but welcome back. Okay, so all these little tiny details. Now here, I still feel like we need a reverb for the entire track, a uniform reverb that everything goes through, or else you can make them sound like they're in different locations. So the reverb I like is called Valhalla Vintage Verb. I got that from Mixbus TV. He recommended it. It's actually really good. It makes the sounds sound really big. So what we can do is go to the instruments tab now and left click to send it to the reverb. So on top of our effects, we also have a reverb return track. And now we're starting to widen out and make these instruments sound alive, as opposed to just stale. I mean, not that they were stale, but. Now, a more advanced technique, people, like if you're trying to squeeze loudness, I was learning from Baphomet, what's his name? Dang. Baphomet something. Forgive me for not knowing your username off the top of my head, because I just found his YouTube stuff. But he likes to clip high frequencies. Now this plugin sometimes gives me problems in FL, but what we're gonna do is clip the high frequencies of the instruments. Since they're mostly high frequencies, we're just gonna use a clipper to try to squeeze loudness. What's up, lights? So let me see if this even does anything. Okay, clip, we're gonna link the input and output, so when I crank this, it's not gonna just be louder. Now we don't have a lot of transients either because we use the compressor. This may be better for like the percussion, because this isn't transient heavy material, which is the pointy part of the audio that eats up a lot of space. Yeah, please, I'm glad he named the tracks, thank God, but can you imagine if this just said insert 50? I would be throwing these waves somewhere. Chimes. I didn't produce the record, so I'm not gonna like step in. Maybe after, if I hear the vocals and we do the remix contest, we can show ways to rearrange it and remix it. So let's hear what this percussion's on. Let's mute the instruments. So I'm gonna send the percussions to the reverb at a very light level, not as much as our instruments. I don't think the percussion has that much transient activity. So now everything's managed to a degree. So this is how you can have a lot of things be in control, because now all those instruments, even though there's a lot of them, they're all going through the same compressor. So it doesn't feel like this overwhelming thing anymore, because everything's going through one compressor. We'll be right back. So there's a little timing with the Bape. That'd be so fire. Once we get into merch, if we ended up doing a collab, because Bape started collabing with everybody. I'm like, y'all really collabing with Nickelodeon TV shows? It's got a little weird after a while. So what I'm going to do is slide the bass, because I think the bass is tastefully off the grid, but at the same time, I feel like it would probably sound better if I nudge this to the left. So let me figure out why my slip button is not activating. Okay, so we're going to hit Alt, left click the slip button, and I'm going to line that up with the grid so that the bass is more on the grid instead of delayed. I think it sounds better on the grid. That's a production decision though. So you got to be careful with those decisions. Also, I think one of these snares is a little delayed. We'll figure out which one it is. Wait, one of these snares is off. It's like, I think it's this one. So what we're gonna do, so in Ableton, it would be a little bit easier because you could see how it's early. You could visually see it's not on the grid. We're gonna hit Alt. Actually, no, we're gonna grab the pencil tool, hit Alt, left click, and drag this to the right so it lines up with the grid. Stuff sounds better late than it does early, in my opinion. Now, what you could do, my mouse is clicking stuff by accident. What you could do is manually chop each of these snares and then line them up. But again, that's a production decision. So it depends on how much work I want to put in, but these are kind of off the grid. But it's because it's off the grid that it takes away from the performance. So as a producer who's kind of A&R in this project, I'm going to go ahead and make sure these are, and I'm putting in work that it's not even going to go to Keyshawn this way anyway. So I don't know why I'm putting in all this work. But basically, we're going to copy and paste those snares that are on the grid instead of the ones that are not on the grid, because it sounds awkward with them off the grid. But the question is, do these snares go all the way throughout the song? And the answer is no, which means that's a lot of copy and pasting to do, and I don't have time for that. So what I'm going to do is leave it as is. We're not going to do all that. This is a time waster. Yeah, this is R&B. Argentine in the house. Oops. Also, be careful not to click anything by accident. You can end up moving a track off the grid by accident. The bass was a little more quantized, but again, there's nothing really you can really do with audio. You can in New Time, but again, it takes up so much time to do it. In Ableton, you could just click time warps, but we don't. Again, that still takes time though. Okay, so the bass is really loud. Now we have to figure out the priority. Do we want the bass or the drums to be loud? There's still a couple issues with the bass and the kicks because there's two things fighting. Remember, slower frequencies have more chance to run into each other. So we need to make sure they don't run into the same frequencies at the same time. And part of the kick and part of the, I think it's like a something, one of these tracks. Let's solo only the lows. Let me turn off. Oh wait, let's keep that on. Just so you guys can hear, because if you hear everything all at once, it'll distract you. But once you kind of solo stuff, you'll start to hear it. There's like a boom, boom sound. And then one of these percussions has like a low frequency, like a, it's just, it's not tonal, but it's like. So we gotta take out those low frequencies. It's like, so I think it's this sound here, this bongo. Let's look at the frequency. Way too much low end on the bongo. Let's cut out the lows. All those low frequencies add up, like I said. So I'm taking out anything that doesn't need low frequencies. There's another sound in here though. So he layered the kick that goes boom, and then there's a regular kick. So the mistake here is that he grouped some sounds, but not every, he didn't group the majority of sounds. So this sound, we want to take out the boom part, but we want to keep the punchy part. But the problem is they're on the same track, and there's no way to separate it. So now we have to figure out a way to handle that without destroying the sound. So I'm going to use a compressor with a tight, let's use our compressor from Waves. And I want the volume to go down after a certain amount of time. So I'm going to compress after a certain amount of time. So we're going to set the attack to like 30 milliseconds. So anything after 30 milliseconds gets pulled down in volume. And that will take care of the tail of the sound. So it goes boom, but it's not as loud. So 40 milliseconds, 50 milliseconds. Okay, so we kind of, you know, it's not the perfect sound, but at least we handled that boom. Also, we could EQ that to a degree using a dynamic EQ that boom. Let's figure out what frequency that is. It's really hard to see. So it's like, it's in that zone. So we're gonna make a wide Q here, which is a lower Q value. And we are going to tell it to be dynamic. I know I'm doing a lot of stuff, but basically we're using a dynamic EQ. So every time it goes boom, it's gonna pull back the volume. So it's not as aggressive. So it's, we're taking away some stuff, but it's, for the whole picture, it helps. Counter belief, we're gonna send the bass to the reverb, give it that 90 sound, but pull it back a lot. So a tiny bit of reverb, not a lot. Yeah, I like Q3. I used to not understand why people liked it, but now I get it. It's because it has a lot of advanced features on it. I don't do this for everybody. This is just the song we picked for the song challenge. So just join our Discord. All the information is there. So if you're still confused about the record label stuff, how to submit songs, when song feedback, all those questions are answered in the Discord. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/discord. Benoga, what's up? Or is it Ben OG? But yes, that's all the answers are answered. All the questions are answered in the Discord. Okay, so now I'm gonna move a little bit quicker because I'm trying to describe everything and save time at the same time, which is a very arduous task. So now I'm just gonna mix the groups to be quick about it. This would take a lot more time. But now we're gonna mix the drums as a group. So you can see if we go to the drum group, we're hitting at -6, but nothing here shows that we're that loud. It's all these things combined that equal -6. And it's mostly this kick, transient energy. So what we're going to do is use some form of a saturator. Let's try, I'm trying to think, what's a saturator we could do on this one? We could do Isotopes Exciter and only focus on frequencies above, let's say 200 Hertz. This is gonna square off some of those transients for me. Pull back the mix level. Put on oversampling mode so it doesn't sound too hard. So let's turn off the instruments for a sec and just ask ourselves, how thick do the drums sound? I'm gonna turn the bass off too. So again, we're looking at it as a whole. So now that's hitting at -10-ish with the kick, because I use that saturator. Without the saturator, the kick's hitting at what, -7. So with the saturator on, the kicks, the transients are being handled because they're being squared off to a degree. Still need to handle these. So let's run it through a soft clipper. There's a clipper. Okay, so now we need to add the roundness back to it, the oomph, some people call it. Let's do a Pultec EQ. I think, which one is it? EQ PB. I always mix these up. Yes, this one. I think I've tried BeatMaker 3 once on the iPad. You like the fruity compressor sound? So we're gonna pull this up at, it really just needs like 90 hertz, but let's boost at 100. I've also found that when you boost the highs, sometimes it adds, somehow a snare got in here. Oh, we're on the drum track. Duh. Forgot we're on the drum track. But I do like the 2.5K on this EQ. So I still don't like that bump. So I'm gonna go back to the kick. It's just too much bass. So yeah, it sounds like a Cardinal Sin to take out bass, but this one just had too much bass in it. Then I'm gonna add another point and boost it like this. So we're just focusing on the area around 90 hertz and all the other stuff around it, we're pulling it down because it's too wonky sounding. So that's how you tame the bass kick thing that was there. I still think the womp could be handled better. And again, this will be easier on speakers because you feel bass more than you hear it. Okay, so let's turn everything back on. So the drums are really loud right now, so we need to pull the output down so that we're back where we started. That's called gain staging. It's when you monitor where you... Gain staging is when you monitor the input and output volume. So before we added this EQ, we were at what, -7? After the EQ, without messing with this gain knob, we were at like -2. We were at -2. So we've added 5 dB of gain. So we need to pull back 5 dB. We don't want to trick the ear into thinking that we're doing something. We're just trying to rebalance frequencies. I think this is a Nipsey Hussle type beat. I didn't make the beat, by the way. This is by Nippy Cray, ironically enough. Nippy Cray made this beat. So let's A-B the drums. Here's without. They're just more, it feels more polished and linear. Could use a little more life, but I'm gonna do that life on the bus, not the individual drum track. Okay, so we have the instruments, we have the drums, we have the percussion. So now I'm gonna mix very quickly to kind of move this forward. We've been on this for a while. So I'm gonna turn off my mic and then I'll describe why I did stuff. Yeah, I realized I used to stream on Twitch before. The only reason I stopped is because I switched the software and I forgot to go back to the software once our internet got back up. So right now I just realized the bass wasn't lined up where I thought it was. So I removed it back to line it up. Yeah, and I could pan some individual things. So right now I'm just thinking in groups because it's a lot easier for my brain to say, okay, move the percussion down, move the drums up, move the instruments down, instead of move the maracas left, move the, you know, the harps to the right. You know, it's too micro. So I like to think in macro first, then get into the micro stuff. Also, I need to route the groups back to the mix bus because they were routed to, let's do this. Well, the instruments are going there. So I'm routing everything back to the mix bus. I could, but I don't creatively think they need to be sidechained. You can do that though. You can sidechain the vocals to the instruments so that the instruments lower every time the vocals come in. So now I'm sending everything to the mix bus. Just give me a second to reroute all this. The mix bus, everything should mute. Okay, I was testing my routing. Oh. What is that sound? The freak. This is a sound we clearly missed. Very noisy sound, so I'm going to take out the low end because that sound has so much low end in it and it's just loud. There's like a I'm gonna listen to the entire track from the beginning and say, what is missing? Right now, I don't hear anything missing. And if I don't hear anything missing, then we're gonna focus on the mix bus, which is the combination of everything. And if I have to pan things, everything seems balanced in this case. Let me answer your questions real quick before I do this next step. At the 12K boost on the drums, oh, you said night and day. Yeah, that's just to make the percussion be heard as percussion. You know, we perceive it as the high frequency stuff. So I wanted to boost the high frequency so that when people hear it, they go, oh, that's the high frequency stuff. Even though it has low mid frequencies in it, it's just a perception thing. Do you wish you were using Ableton? Not really. Ableton has good plugins though. Each 4 to 8 bars. Yeah, true. It's very different. Now, you think gain staging is easier in FL? Take both sides of the argument. Why am I having a hard time getting waves effects not showing up in FL? That's a very specific question. You have to use their wave centrals and you have to activate it first. And then you have to go through the process of adding it to FL. So that could be... I would ask their support. It's too deep of a question. It sounds simple, but that's not simple. His name is Nippy Cray. He's on our Discord. He submitted for the song challenge for the record label that we're building. Let me show you what his thing is. So if you scroll down, go to song challenges. Nippy Cray is... Where is he at? Here he is. He's right here. Nippy Cray on Discord at 1:07:2022. The song's called Chilling. And I think he has his social media linked on here. So here's his Instagram right here. So again, come join us in Discord. All your answers are there. Any question you could probably have is on the Discord. Answered on the Discord. So again, I'm gonna start focusing on the mix bus now. And everything's pretty loud right now. Are y'all hearing that too? It's going like meow, 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 meow. Why does the bass sound like that? Wait a sec. I was like, the bass break? Had to double check. So here's a bass change I didn't hear when we were doing what we were doing. So what I'm gonna do for this is, I'm trying to think, what could we do for the bass? It needs a snappy compressor and it needs the lows tamed. So this the base is like three different bases in one. So what I'm going to do is just kind of override the majority of the flaw here. It's going to interrupt one of the two sounds, but take care of that last sound. The white stuff is making it bigger, making it louder. That's all it's doing. Give me 1 sec to focus on this bass though. That sound's going through a 4-minute filter and it sounds weird when it's stacked on the other stuff. So I realized what your question was. The Weiss plugins are, let me turn this headphone feedback down. Okay, so the Weiss plugin that I'm using here is to just take out any frequencies that hurt our ears. It just has a, they've done all the science and found the harsh frequencies. So this is a de-esser on the entire track to take care of those harsh, harsh frequencies that I can't even really hear necessarily. The things I may have missed. And again, remember, I'm kind of jumping 1,000 steps because of time. Then we have this plugin, which is just, it makes it louder to a degree. I put it on wide mode, so it's compressing the mono signal so that, the middle signal so that the sides sound louder. So it's just turning the volume down on the middle sound so that the sides sound louder, which creates the perception that the song's wider. So that's what this is doing right here on wide mode. So that is part one on how to mix beats. That took forever, didn't it? 120. Mixing just takes so much time. That wasn't even like half of technically what we're supposed to do. You have to go back and forth with the speakers, reference, take care of each frequency band. It's a lot of work. It just takes time. I just am not gonna sit here for 5 hours when we went over the concepts. But that's what you asked for. You asked for the mixing. Do I have a beat mixing masterclass? We have mixing courses at busyworksbeats.com/premium. Not a masterclass per se, because the masterclass would be like 8 hours long. It would just be insanely long. But we have a lot of different separate courses. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. Superb track. I didn't make the track. I'm just mixing it to a degree. And it's a lot of tracks. A lot to account for. It helps in CPU as well. We're over the 2 hour mark. So it just shows how long mixing can take. That's why I don't mix in my videos a lot. It just takes way too much time. How to live stream. Sure, this is somebody who could probably do it more justice than me if you just Google like how to live stream. I mean, not Google, YouTube it on OBS or something like that. Something will pop up. So that took up so much time that I'm gonna wrap it here. I'll probably be on again because we have to go live for the B battle at 8 p.m. tonight, Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern time. So come join us on Discord to hop into the party so that you're not left out and confused. And shout out to everybody. I'm gonna end this.